Meanwhile, the latest Gonzales poll shows if the election were held today, Governor O'Malley would be reelected. 47% of registered likely voters say they will vote for O'Malley. 42% give their support to Ehrlich, while 6% are still undecided. Now, the poll also gives the governor a 48% approval rating. 11 News reporter David Collins begins our Commitment 2010 team coverage with a closer look at those new numbers. David?
Stan, the latest poll appears to signal a trend. Governor O'Malley's lead in the past three statewide surveys is dwindling. The poll is also unique in that it offers a prediction of voter turnout based on party affiliation.
Republican Bob Ehrlich considers this a banner day. He cites an endorsement of the state FOP. Polls trending his way and suddenly becoming flush with campaign contributions. The Ehrlich Kane ticket is crowing about raising $2.8 million in the past 49 days. They claim to have $1.7 million cash on hand.
Now you see what happens in close elections. You see the polls closing, you see the money coming in, you see the endorsements accumulating.
The last three polls find Governor Martin O'Malley's lead dwindling from 11% to 8%. And now, according to Gonzales Research Marketing, O'Malley has a 5-point advantage.
We're really pleased today.
But at least one political expert believes the Gonzales survey undersamples Republicans and African Americans, which could dampen what Ehrlich sees as good news. The same poll predicts Democratic turnout will decline by 7%. Republican turnout will increase by 11%. Unaffiliated voters going to the polls will drop by 2%. Ehrlich has an 8% advantage in Baltimore County, but the poll indicates that's not enough to offset O'Malley's popularity in the D.C. area.
Prince George's County, Montgomery County, and the city of Baltimore have to turn out heavily and vote heavily for the Democratic nominee.
The Gonzales poll finds that O'Malley's TV ads against Ehrlich in the D.C. market is working in his favor, and Ehrlich doesn't disagree.
We got hammered on Washington TV a few weeks ago. We were not up. We didn't have the money. The negative, ludicrous ads obviously had some impact. We now see that impact dissipating.
According to Gonzales, the state's economy remains the number one issue among likely voters. 59% say their financial situation is the same as it was last year. 29% claim it's worse, and only 11% believe things will get better next year. 43% think Maryland is headed in the right direction. 85.3% of African Americans approve of O'Malley's job performance. Only 21.2% have a favorable opinion of Ehrlich.
The African American community makes up about 30% of the state's population, and it votes about 90% Democratic.
Ehrlich launched a new campaign ad over the weekend. It makes it appeal to female voters, and that's not all. Another fact check, new at 6. Reporting live from the studio, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.